Welcome the students of class 8. Welcome to our social science history class. And today in our history class, we are going to discuss the third subunit from your chapter number 11 from old NCERT book. And the name of the chapter is The Making of the National Movement, 1870s to 1947. And our today's topic is, it is freedom is our birthright. It is in page number 144. So open your book and follow. So what happened is that previous class we have read about the moderates. Moderates are the people, those actually the first 20 years, those people who administered the Congress and decided their policies. And the moderates policy are known as the policy of prayers, writing in journals, in newspaper, and also delivering lectures in different places in nook and corner of the country. So these are some activities, and also giving deputation white paper to the governor general or particular authority. But what happened after that? By 1890s, many Indians began to raise question about the political style of the Congress. In Bengal, Maharashtra and Punjab, there are three powerhouses. These three are the powerhouses of all the nationalist movement in India. So leaders such as Bipin Chandra Pal, the Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Lala Lajpat Rai, together called as Lal Bal Pal. So they were beginning to explore more radical objectives and methods. They exercised that they criticized the moderates for their policy of prayers and emphasized the importance of self-reliance and constructive work. They argue that people must rely on their own strength, not on the good intentions of the government. People must fight for their swaraj. So they must fight for their rights, not just writing about their misdeeds in newspaper or journals and creating awareness among the people. It will not going to be successful as per the leaders such as Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal. So Tilak raised the question and raised the slogan that freedom is my birthright and I shall have it. And in 1905, when the Lord Curzon, Viceroy Lord Curzon, partitioned the Bengal, there was a decision that they divide the Bengal, because Bengal at the time is a huge province. They directly acquired the entire Bengal province or Bengal Subah that was under the Mughals. And that time, the Bengal Subah is not a small place. Along with some Bihar and Jharkhand, the entire area, Orissa also there, some part of Assam and Tripura and today's entire Bangladesh and West Bengal. Okay, most of the part of West Bengal actually at the time, all the West Bengal included in the Bengal Subah. And they also administer the Bengal, and these are under their Bengal presidency. So it is a huge place and it is very much difficult to administer as per the British. So at the time, what happened? They decided to argue for dividing Bengal for reasons of administrative convenience. But what did administrative convenience mean? Whose convenience did it represent at the time? The leaders question. And clearly it was closely tied to the interest of British officials and businessmen. Why? Because even so, instead of removing the non-Bengal areas from the province, the government separated East Bengal and merged it with Assam. They are not separating the non-Bengali speaking areas like such as the Bihar. Okay, they actually, what happened, they divided the Bengal into two parts and they decided to merge the Eastern Bengal with the Assam. So what happened? Perhaps the main British motives were to curtail the influence of Bengali politicians to split the Bengali people. So behind this initiative, the Congressi leaders said that there are some other motives also there, that they try to decrease the importance of Bengal in their national politics, because most of the people at that time the ruling on the Congress or some other nationalist organization formed in India are Bengali, such as Surendranath Banerjee, Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Bipin Chandra Pal, and Aurobindo Ghosh. There are a lot of leaders at that time. Okay, so they try to curtail the power of the Bengalis to split their territory into two different areas. So the partition of Bengal infuriated people all over the India. Means people very much angry on this decision, and all sections of the Congress, the moderates and the radicals, as they may be called, opposed it. And meanwhile, there was some incident happened. So what happened against the decision of partition of Bengal? Large public meetings and demonstrations were organized, and novel methods of mass protest developed. The students, the different professionals, they came to the street protesting against the government, and the struggle that unfolded came to be known as the Swadeshi movement. And that movement that was organized by the common people in the leadership of Congress and some other nationalist organization known as the Swadeshi movement. So what was the Swadeshi movement? That this movement, what happened, people started accepting the Indian goods and boycotting the Western goods. They're burning the Western goods, whatever they have purchased or gathered in their home, and they started accepting the Indian cotton textiles woven on the handloom, okay, and Indian cookware such as the clay pots and everything. And they also established various nationalist educational institute in that time, such as the Vishwabharati also, and also established in that time in 1905, and the national and also in Calcutta various institutes established. Among them, one of them was the Jadavpur University and Bengal Chemical and Pharmaceutical Works. Okay, so this type of organization also established at the time. So strongest in Bengal, but with effects elsewhere too. Not the Swadeshi movement not only affected the Bengal, but the other parts of the country also. In Deltaic Andhra Pradesh, for instance, it's known as Bande Mataram movement. In Andhra Pradesh, it known as Bande Mataram movement, and also it was very much popular. The leaders such as Bal Gangadhar Tilak also published some newspaper against the oppressive policies of the British government, such as Keshari, a Maratha newspaper edited by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. The Swadeshi movement sought to oppose British rule and encourage the ideas of self-help, Swadeshi entrepreneurship and national education, and the use of Indian languages to fight for Swaraj. And the radicals advocated mass mobilization and boycott of British institution and goods. They started picketing in front of the British shops, and some individuals also began to struggle the revolutionary violence would be necessary to overthrow British rule. And some people also thought that the mass agitation is not the only process. Along with the policy of prayers and mass agitation that was organized by the radicals, the revolutionary violence also started. Means some to use the violence to make a radical change within the country. And in Bengali, there are a lot of revolutionary leaders such as Khudiram Bose, they martyred. Prafullo Chaki, Khudiram Bose, Bagha Jyotin, or Jyotirindranath Mukherjee, they were martyred. And in other parts of the country also, other martyrs also, they sacrificed their life for their country, and in some secret terrorist or secret revolutionary activity. So the opening decades of the 20th century were marked by other developments as well. A group of Muslim landlords and nawabs formed an organization that was named All India Muslim League. It was formed in 1906. All India Muslim league. And it desired separate electorates for Muslims, and it demanded considered by the government, and its demand considered by the government in 1909. And some seats of the council of the governor general were now reserved for the Muslim candidates who would be elected by Muslim voters. And this tempted politicians to gather a following by distributing favors to their own religious groups. And this actually tempted the other religions also, and some other politicians also. They found a new way, a new line of politics based on religion. Meanwhile, the Congress split in 1907. What happened? In 1907, Congress also split up. There is a big fight among the two different type of people because of their different ideologies. Leaders such as Bipin Chandra Pal, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Arvind Ghosh, they argued against the policy of prayers, and they were walked out from the Congress. The session of Congress that was held in Surat in 1907, and this incident in the history known as Surat split. Okay, this incident known as Surat split. So the moderates were opposed to the use of boycott, and they felt that it involved the use of force. But what happened? The moderates, they opposed. Why? There was some disagreement between these two groups, because the moderates were opposed the use of boycott of British goods because they felt that it involved the use of force. After the split, the Congress came to be dominated by the moderates, with Tilak's followers functioning from outside. And the two groups reunited in December 1950. Reunion of two groups, the moderates and radicals inside the Congress in 1915. And the very next year, the Congress and the Muslim League signed the historic Lucknow Pact and decided to work together for representative government in the country. And Gandhiji also arrived after that in 1916, and the change of national movement, the course of national movement totally changed. Okay, students, so next day we're going to discuss about the national movement led by Mahatma Gandhi. So thank you for watching. See you in the next class with this subunit.